Welcome back to Tompadula TV and to the second segment of Program 4. This time I read two poems about Australia and then call on all participants in this very particular celebration to come and sing Advance Australia Fair once again. And now, we're coming towards the end of what has been a very enjoyable afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I want to remind you that if you wish to look at any of our work that we've carried out over the last 20 years and the last 10 on community TV here in Melbourne, we've accumulated quite a range of different types of what someone calls playlists on TomPadulaTV.com. Don't forget, you can watch us right here from one of these anytime you like, 24/7. So, TomPadulaTV.com. And I'd like to complete this afternoon reminding ourselves of Australia. There are two poems here which I've written a while back called, one is called Absorbed and the other one is called Australia. So the first one, they're quite short, Absorbed. You are so far away there in that town lost in the plains, where the dust dries up the lips, where the beer satisfies the throat burned by the heat. Whilst you drink, you tell me, I have need of peace, and you add, I need solitude. Australia is a land which absorbs you in its roots. Without you realising it, I point out aloud. Yes, it's really true, he reflects, whilst his glance takes him somewhere else, where sure of itself, nature reigns over everything else. And that's what happens. Nature reigns over everything else here in Australia. And finally, Australia, dry land, serene in your desert, which pulsates only at the shouts of the ants and the aborigines, true Australians, wise of the land which owned them. Civilization takes its definition from the environment, from the colour of the flowers, from the warmth of the days which change only to go dreaming in the extended plains, lacking in trees and water. But we've had plenty of water in the last year, thanks to La Niña. So after the period of El Niño, both El Niño and La Niña live in the Pacific. We have to expect what's to come. And I'd like to say only this, that our governments in the future should perhaps think of Australian cities, towns, all over the country as a castle during the Renaissance, where you have like a little lake around the castle. So when we built, let's not forget that we suffer from dry weather and wet weather, and therefore we have to make provision for it in the future. Whatever we do in this context, it's for us, it's for the children who come after us, for the generations to come. Money is always well spent when it does help us live more comfortably in this wonderful continent of ours called Australia, which is also our land. Tanti auguri all'Australia. Best wishes to Australia Day. And that was in 2009. We're already in 2011. And therefore, this year, we haven't brought out a newsletter, a booklet. This time, it's only been a newsletter. But in the future, who knows, we'll do something bigger than this. So thank you very much for the afternoon. Thank you to the camera people, David and Tom. Thank you very much to Angel, Dora, and Nicola, to everyone else here. I'd like to call on now those people who have participated, quelli che hanno partecipato, di venire dietro qua, and I want you to play Advance Australia Fair once again. Australians, all rejoice, for we are young and free. We golden so well for toil, for home with the our land of in In joyful strains, then let us sing a dance of celebration. Beneath our lady, sudden cross will call with hearts and hands. Tonight is coming far. In and of all the land, for those who come across the sea, in joyful strains, then let us sing Advance, O Saviour. Bravi, thank you. Thank you very much. Well, that was it at Teatro Padula with Australia Day celebration 2011. But we have a little treat for you like we normally do. So stay tuned for segment 3 of program 4.